I had a conversation today with my peer support worker. He's also autistic. He's very knowledgeable. We always talk because he has to remind me. I still, even, you know, you'd think with all my advocacy that I would have it straight, but really when we're brought up in a world that has very little knowledge, let alone understanding of the autistic cognitive divergence, the neurological divergence, you still feel like there's something wrong with you. And I now say it's a circumstantial disability where systems and people don't have knowledge as to how the autistic brain works and how the autistic brain and body type and person is able to communicate and, you know, what their processing speed and type looks like and means. What he reminds me is that we polyprocess. We are so deep and so complex and detailed and fluid and objective that we're polyprocessing. So because we're polyprocessing and because we're faster, we are actually slowed down by that. So we're slowed down probably about 1.5 times on average. So we're slowed down, you know, either 1.5 or 2 times as much because we're polyprocessing and because we're processing so much detail, it inevitably takes us longer. And he was calling that the cognitive variance. And so here we are thinking that we're slower. We're actually just more richly complex and detailed, and we can't help but be this way. And there's gifts to that, immense gifts to that, but there's also drawbacks to it, considering our situation of now and the way that systems are run, which are, you know, not accommodating to this processing type and sensory friendly or anything. And it doesn't mean to like completely baby the situation. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about making some reasonable adjustments, and then we work on the rest, because some of the issues we have, they're exacerbated in a negative way by our health. That's what I think causes the, would explain the more severe forms of autism and whatnot. I think that this natural cognitive variance and neurological divergence is there, and then on top of that gets like amplified in a way that can be detrimental, even debilitating, because of mainly the sensory system being in overdrive. And it's a reaction to environmental factors. With autistic people, it's more likely to happen, both immune system and neurological system and endocrine systems. It's the system freaking out in defensiveness and fight or flight to all of the foreign invaders that really are not good for the body to be encountering. I just think autistic people are more sensitive to that, and, you know, the best thing we can do to optimize our functionality, as I call it in my poem, to optimize our functionality, we could be as healthy and balanced as possible. And the rest, though, is finding ways to self-care and set boundaries and limits with others and with yourself, too. Know when you get too overloaded. Know what the triggers are. Use your sensory gear. When I'm outside, I'm very auditory, and I can hear everything, and it hurts. I'm very musical, so I'm very, very auditory. I seek out good auditory, melodic auditory, like music, but cars, traffic, and all these conflicting sounds really make me batty. So I always have to have ear guards when I'm outside and in any kind of a busy place, and I can remove them and wear them on my neck here and there. I also have sunglasses too. I have a hard time with really bright lights and stuff. My visual is fairly sensitive too, but auditory is a bit more. I always make sure that I'm in like comfy clothing and without tags and right kind of materials that are soft and a little bit flexible and breathable. But also, I actually like to have fitted clothing that's kind of hugging me, as long as it's got a nylon or elastic in it, stretchy. And social boundaries. Everybody's different, but it's about learning social limits. I have a blog called Learning Social Limits. Even though we may seem social or socially capable, a lot of us can seem quite articulate and socially capable. That might be a savant. Like in my case, it's a savant, but I can really get squirrely if I give myself too much of a dose of that at once. It'll cause me to need to go shut down. I need to walk and process the script to process the language that I took in and put out and all this kind of thing. So that's another video though. But the social boundaries piece is important. It's important both on the internet, social boundaries, which is something I learned the hard way, and in the real world. In both cases, social boundaries and social limits, finding ways to connect with people as best as you can without overwhelming the brain and the body. It's a hard one sometimes, but it's very important to find ways to connect that aren't fork heavy. Forks are a measure of social energy. I have a blog called The Fork Theory too. The Fork Theory is something that my friend Tanya came up with first. I adapted that theory. It's the same as the spoon theory with physical health issues, like a spoon. You know, if you lack stamina physically, dealing with a physical chronic health challenge, it's the same thing. Forks are like that for mental energy and social energy, social stamina. Like a big meeting with a lot of people, it could be many forks, and it could be like, whoa, I have no more forks. And like a short phone conversation, like making an inquiry, is like a fork. And maybe a longer phone conversation is two or three forks. Anyway, so yeah, taking care of your cognitive variance and your neurologically diverse needs is important, to recognize that that's okay, because autistic people suffer health-wise, mood-wise, behavioral is affected, and then this is where all these judgments come about. It stems from overdoing, outdoing your own limits in terms of your needs for your autistic brain wiring. So yeah, and I'm learning over time. You know, I've been through a lot and I've had to learn it because of the way my health is. I've had to learn to get to know myself and get to know what my needs are and what my boundaries are. I've written a lot about it in my book, Beyond the Boxes, as well as my autobiography. So yeah, I'll share more as I go along.